Welcome to the Emergency Planning Team's training DVD. Over the next 30 minutes, you're about to see what happens when the police officially hand over control from a major flood incident to the multi-agency silver control team shown here. If you're going to be involved in a team like this or part of an emergency management team, then the following footage will help you to understand what's involved. However, before we watch the exercise, let's just take a few minutes to set the scene and explain just a few basic principles. The first one we need to cover is that all major incidents break down into two key phases, the rescue phase and then the recovery phase. Rescue is obviously the life-saving phase of the incident and usually controlled by the police. However, limited exceptions to this do occur if the incident involves a fire or other dangerous hazards, in which case the fire service will usually have overall control until the immediate danger has passed. Once this life-saving rescue phase is complete, overall control of the incident will usually be handed to the multi-agency silver control team. So, now that you understand the two key phases of an incident, let's take a look at the command structure as it's used in both phases and its core to the successful management of the incident. Emergency services in the United Kingdom use a command structure that's referred to as gold, silver, and bronze. This command structure is used to establish a hierarchical framework for the command and control of major incidents and disasters. However, it should be noted that some agencies use the terms strategic, tactical, and operational. Gold is responsible for making the strategic decisions about what to do next. Silver decides how to action the decisions made by gold. And bronze, the officers on the ground, assisted by responders, will carry out these orders. This tried and tested procedure works because information is continually passed up and down the chain of command to create a clear picture of the incident at every level. This means that all the emergency services can view the whole incident, assess the priority issues, the resources available, and also the situation on the ground. The multi-agency control team uses the same command structure to manage the incident during the recovery phase. For example, if the multi-agency silver control is passed information about debris or refuse that needs to be removed from within the Biddeford area, they'll ask the Torridge District Council representative on the team to address this issue as quickly as possible. The Torridge District Council representative will then pass this request down line to his or her emergency management team, who prioritises the request and, when possible, sends someone out to collect and remove the debris or rubbish. Once actioned, the cleanup team on site will supply an update to the EMT, who in turn pass this information back up to the Torridge representative at Silver Control. So, now we've covered the phases and command structure, let's set the scene. It's now 72 hours after the incident and the rescue phase has now finished. As such, Devon and Cornwall Constabulary are now officially handing over to the multi-agency silver control team.
As a result of a series of small low-pressure systems. By the 6th of the 11th, it was determined that one of the low-pressure systems, which was being monitored and had reached a low of 970 megabytes, was on course to hit the southwest of the UK. The associated swell was such that it
To do this, the police representative has to supply a full debrief that highlights the following: the events leading up to the incident itself, and what happened up to this point in time. With this in mind, the main points covered are as follows: the severe weather warnings and flood warnings issued by the Met Office, when the gold control was set up, the emergency responses from all the agencies involved, the opening of the rest centres, the opening of silver control, when the flood defences were overtopped, and the number of properties and areas affected by the floods.
Established by the Devon, Cornwall and Isles of Scilly Local Resilience Forum, the Devon and Cornwall Constabulary assumed responsibility as the lead coordinating agency from the time a major incident was declared on the 8th of November. The Devon and Cornwall Constabulary have continued in that role during the erection, rescue and retrieval phases of the incident, and the Devon and Cornwall Constabulary has now completed the retrieval phase. Therefore, in accordance with this protocol, the Devon and Cornwall Constabulary now relinquishes as the role as the lead coordinating agency, which is passed to the relevant local authority, in this case, the North Devon District Council and Torridge District Council. From the time and date shown below, all responsibility for the coordination of the remediation and regeneration phases of the incident passed to these councils, including all further responsibility for safety of the public, provision of adequate resources, and all financial arrangements relating to this incident.
With the police handover completed, Silver Control are now fully responsible for the recovery operation from this point onwards. With this in mind, the Silver Control chairperson then delivers his own pre-prepared 72-hour situation report to set the scene for all the agencies involved. It should be noted that the police handover and the chairperson's situation report are also delivered to all the downline emergency management teams. This course of action ensures that all the parties involved have a good idea about what's happened and the current situation.
Due to the limited notice available for this event, we were very pleased with the support offered in assisting DCC with accommodation, which required considerable efforts in organising warning and informing and transportation.
In this instance, the chairperson provides a situation report that covers the following: the infrastructure problems concerning roads and railways, the number of properties that are still without power, the loss of communication, the number of people still in rest centres, the issues regarding panic buying, and finally the challenges of security for buildings affected by the floods.
Without its assistance, we will find it difficult to continue our response. It would be fair to say that lessons have been learned, which hopefully will be addressed as we presently continue work on the RRF Mass Evacuation Plan, which is still very much work in progress.
When the chairperson has completed his situation report, he'll then obtain reports from all the agencies around the table. In this instance, the following agencies are in attendance: North Devon Council, Torridge District Council, the Environment Agency, Devon and Cornwall Constabulary, Devon and Somerset Fire Rescue, Airsea Rescue, Devon County Council, Western Power, the Women's Rural Voluntary Service, the Primary Care Trust, and the Health Protection Agency. Each agency update will highlight the key issues that they're responsible for. So, let's take a quick look at just a couple of these updates.
And we have to consider things like those doing it in this area of meals
and wheels. Associated with infectious diseases and chemical hazards, and there are some associated hazards.
Checking that the fences are not damaged, and making sure that repairs are hand ones that are...
40% of staff.
Our staff are currently having issues in access to areas as a result of flood water.
Those associations require replacement of large heavy plant and switchgear. Inspection of the surrounding areas have reduced the flood water still being.
Now let's take a closer look at an update from Ken Miles, the representative from Torridge District Council. Ken highlights that the council staff have been on standby since the beginning of the incident, identifying alternative housing for anybody displaced by the flood. Although successful in many instances, his team are still struggling to find shelter for over 1,000 people. He also highlights the following key points. The flood has affected most of the council's buildings. Some people have returned to their homes but still don't have utilities. Operational services are carrying out risk assessments to see if it's safe to start cleaning the flooded areas. Some clean-up work has started and skips have been located to help. He also highlights that he has concerns that these skips will be filled very quickly. Building control, health and safety, environmental health, and food safety officers have all been deployed and are in the process of investigating homes and businesses. And finally, the TDC has resource issues regarding the number of officers available and required. Now let's listen to two of the other agencies delivering their updates.
The pumping operation to date has been very successful, and combined with the help from other agencies, there are only two main areas to finish, which are Pottington in Barnstable and Easter Water in Biddeford, which we hope to finish today. Crews will also be involved in pumping out other remaining pooled areas. A number of our retained members in Barnstable have had their homes affected by the flood water, which means that they have been displaced and cannot now give fire cover, which could impact on our resilience in the near future. Due to the damage to the road structure around Pilton, we've had to set up a temporary base at Roundswell.
Where we would be able to help, obviously, is access to the hospital, standby fuel, and any medium lift. Daylight hours, we'd be able to provide two SAR helicopters with medium lift, and during the night periods, one SAR helo, otherwise we're going to run out of crews fairly quickly. There is obviously a potential to call in support helicopter forces from around the military elsewhere. And again, that will be done through the regional liaison officers. So that's really...
The key issues seem to be power, flooding still, roads closed,
lack of accommodation, and we need some solutions. And it turned to us to provide those solutions. So I think for the next half an hour or so, I think we need to try and explore what the solutions might be. How do we provide sufficient housing? We need to recover people from the rest centres, which are out of county at the moment. We need to bring them back home as far as possible.
Now let's jump away from Silver Control for a while to watch Torridge District Council's emergency management team. As you probably guessed, the EMT is directly linked to the Silver TDC representative, Ken Miles, who we just saw delivering his update. All the information supplied by Ken to Silver came directly from this team. Now, let's jump backwards in time and join the team back at the start of the exercise. So this section actually picks up from the end of the Silver Chairperson's update.
There is here, which I will give you a copy of, a list of the payers and facilitators.